last time on Age of Darkness Romance Twilight, you discovered through going through the maze that there were many more secrets than you thought. You met people, you fought monsters, some more difficult than others. You also traveled through the maze with some people as your allies. Now, coming to the end of the maze, you find yourself face to face with a monster unseen like any before. Last time I had you roll for initiative, so we're going to go off of that.
15.
It was 15.
Mm-hmm.
Now this monster, we're going to recap where we were before. It was making weird noises, like... And then it pushed itself towards you, moving left, right, left, right. And then it came for a slash towards you. And we're going to resume from here. So as it slashes at you, I'm going to have you make a dex save to try and dodge. Because... And, this is going to be a big thing.
Wow.
So what was your dex?
I did a fail.
So you roll a critical failure. So it's gonna hit you, but it only rolled a 9 to hit you. So it's only going to slash at you somewhat. Now, since you rolled a dex, you're going to fall over, try to find out what's your footing. So what's happening is, as it's coming at you, it slashes for a swing. You try to dodge it, and it slashes you on your way down. You back up. Fall onto the ground.
How much damage do I take?
Okay, so as it slashes at you, you fall back, and it only cuts you at about half, so you take about half of the damage it would have. So I would say like 24.
What?
This thing swings for a lot. You would have taken more damage, but because it,
I'll take 24.
Yeah. This thing has like sights. I don't know if you've ever seen Dead Man Wonderland, but there's this character that has sights coming out of its arms. So it's gonna follow up to try and attack Bethany, because it's a very fast creature. It can attack twice. It's gonna roll to hit Bethany. It actually doesn't, it misses Bethany, so Bethany is gonna go, "Oh, Thomas! Oh, me!" And then Bethany throws up his arms to block it, and he blocks the swing, the slash from the monster. Bethany goes, "Oh, what is this thing?" So now you can, follow up to what you're doing next, because it just had its turn. It's really close on you guys. It's like right on top of Bethany. You're on the ground right next to it.
I'm gonna get up and try to chop him.
Chop him?
Yeah, with my katana.
Slashing the thing all the way from the bottom of his body all the way to the top. Back up a bit. So it didn't back up a lot because it wasn't his turn. It just used it as a reaction to you, so it backed up a few feet. It's Bethany's turn, and he's gonna go, "Thomas, are you okay?" Reaches out his hand to grab you. I mean, you're already up off the ground, but he reaches out to grab you, like, to pull you back.
I'm good, Bethany, but let's take this thing down.
All right. Do you have any special ideas? He says that as he's running, "Do you have any ideas?" So he's gonna say that as he runs towards the thing with its battle axe. and Bethany's gonna swing to hit it.
Let's just kill this motherfucker.
So it has a high high armor class. It's gonna bob and weave, slide right out from the battle axe, actually kind of like the Matrix dodging it. And since he missed, he's gonna go back in for an attack, but this time at Bethany, slashing its claws at Bethany. But it misses. Bethany has a good armor class as well. So as Bethany's a big, bulky man, he's gonna block the attack again. This time Bethany's gonna react by grabbing the arm and try and throw it against the hedge wall. Using its Bethany's strength, but the thing was too slippery, slips out of the grip of Bethany, and backs up more.
Can I get a free action and light a cigarette?
Yeah, it's a free action.
Can I light the cigarette? I got the sound effect.
You say you pull out a cigarette and light it?
Oh yeah, that's hit the spot. All right, Bethany, I think I got an idea how to take this thing down.
Any idea? What's your idea, son?
Let's hit it really hard together.
Oh, just like we did back at that snake. It's a good idea.
Exactly.
So, you guys are gonna flank together. You're going to the left. Bethany's going to the right. So, because you guys are attacking together, you have advantage. You're swinging at the thing. But the thing's smart. It's actually humanoid. It's gonna see you both and then back up. It's not even going to engage either of you. It's just gonna back up even more. So, as you guys look towards the monster, you guys see where you're finally fighting. You see you're fighting in an area surrounded by the hedge wall. Whereas, it's a huge open area with a big mansion-ish manor. I'd say it's like got the style of a mansion, but it's actually only like two floors.
And your house?
Kind of like my house if it was twice the size. It's it's really big, but it's not longer. As big as a mansion.
It's longer, not taller.
Longer, not taller.
Got
so,
it.
Bethany goes, "Oh man, I haven't seen this thing in a while."
What is this thing?
This was the witch's den, I believe. There was someone that lived here. And then, because you guys are talking, the thing is looking you guys and actually can rush you. It's his turn. Okay. So, as a reaction, it backed up on your guys' attack, and it's gonna swing. It's gonna attack you guys again. Now, this time, when it attacks, it's going to go low, and as it goes low at you, the hood comes off of it, you see all the spider eyes on the top of it. It's got tons of eyes just looking at you.
Oh, this thing's weird.
Let's go for the axe, Bethany.
So as it swings at you, you're gonna dodge it just in time.
Bethany, let's attack the eyes together.
That's a good idea. Let's go. So it's closer to you now. It's going to see Bethany coming. It has to make a con save. What's cool about this is that because you kind of skipped your turn to roll with Bethany, and it's closer this time, Bethany's going to attack it. It has to make a save to dodge Bethany, but you're attacking it as well, so you get free damage in at this point, at this time. So it's gonna take 10 damage. It's gonna be like backing up damage. So it's gonna dodge Bethany's attack, take your damage, and then back up. It's back to where it was a turn or two ago.
Who made this beast?
I don't know. It seems this witch had some sort of ability. I can't really know anything about that myself.
Think her, she had a devil fruit to make like an army?
It could be possible. I haven't seen any devil fruits in a while.
Beast got knocked back and me and Bethany started talking.
The beast is actually gonna back up even more. It's gonna basically leave your guys' sight. It's very fast, so it's gonna use its turn to run towards the manor. So that means it's like, it's your turn, but also combat is kinda at a standstill right now.
Bethany.
Ugh. That thing was strange. It's a good thing we knocked it back for a little while. We need to keep our eye out.
But right, run like that.
It runs fast.
Let's approach the manor.
So you guys are gonna approach the manor. It's been about 6 to 7 hours since you entered the maze. It's been about 8 to 9 hours since you first met George. So, when you first met George, it was about 7 p.m. So I would say right now it's about early morning, 4 a.m. Since it's early morning, you guys feel water start to drip down. Oh, I think it's raining.
Either that or it's morning dew.
It's a morning dew.
Y'all ever heard of this drink called a Mountain Dew? Tastes amazing.
Mountain Dew? Oh, they have those in the Grand Line.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh.
Oh, you never been to the Grand Line?
No, not by myself.
It's a dangerous place. Though you might already know that.
Well, I know that's where I have to conquer the Grand Line, so... Well, I gotta conquer it. I'm King of the Pirates, damn it.
King of the Pirates? What's that?
Where if I conquer the Grand Line, I'll become the best well-known pirate and crew out there. I just need a crew first. Bethany, why don't you join my crew?
We can talk more about that another time. Right now, I just want to get out of this alive. As you guys are talking, you hear... So you look above you and make a perception check to see if you see it. So you see it coming, but Bethany doesn't. It's gonna Assassin's Creed basically jump on top of you guys. You can try and warn Bethany in time.
No? I push him. Can
you're,
I push him?
You're gonna push him? Okay. So the two of you look up and you see the monster you were just fighting jumping down on top of you guys. And as just before it hits you both, because you're standing close to each other, you push Bethany out of the way, and it hits you instead. So it's gonna fall on top of you, Assassin's Creed style, and slash you against the arm because you threw your hands up to block it. And you're gonna take 29 points of damage here.
Jesus.
This thing is dangerous.
I know.
And Bethany's gonna go, "Oh, get off my friend!" So it's gonna slice his battle axe against the thing, try to make a hit. Bethany's gonna swing and hit this thing right across the face. Wasn't a lot, but at least it got it off of you. It didn't take a lot of damage. Bethany hits it, it falls off of you. It like gets up and gets its bearings.
Bethany, protect me, I gotta heal.
Alright, I got you. Bethany's gonna stand in front of you.
How much health does syringes do?
Your full HP, 15% of that.
If I'm full, I'm at 49 right now.
Your full HP is 100, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so 15. It heals for 15. One. It costs a full action to do it.
That's
so
right.
Bethany hit, and the thing is going to attack, and then you can heal. The thing is gonna try and get revenge. Slap. Go towards Bethany. Using a weird... Not using its slashing claws, but trying to bite Bethany instead. It puts itself at a vulnerable position to deal more damage. So Bethany has a chance to see this coming and dodge it.
Is he attacking, or do I have a turn?
You're behind Bethany, about to heal. Bethany just hit this thing, stood in front of you. The thing is going to attack Bethany. You're standing behind Bethany. Let me see. And then it's going to... Bethany is going to make a save. Okay, nice. Bethany is going to grab it by the neck and slam it into the ground. Doing so, however, is going to make Bethany subjected to its bite. So it's basically they're both going to slam and do damage against each other at the cost of their HPs. You're going to heal.
Pop the syringe.
That's going to take your full action, but you can obviously still talk if you wanted to like converse with Bethany. I got your back, brother.
Bethany, think you still holding down?
I'll try. You're healing back there. After you heal, Bethany's gonna take the monster again and try to hit it, but it's gonna react fast enough to dodge, gathering its bearings. So once again, It gets back on its feet. It like crawled away really weirdly. Like, kind of like how a spider would, but without the eight legs. Get back here, you cretin! That's a new word for me. What do you think, Thomas?
Just hold it down so I can try to step it.
I'm not. Are you trying to step on bugs now? I see.
I hate pets.
Let's kill this thing, Thomas.
Let's do it.
Now, the creature is away from you guys now, and, Bethany wants to try and attack him, but... It can make its turn now, and it's gonna leave. You guys were fighting in front of the manor, and as you were fighting in front of the manor, this all happened. Now, it's gone. You don't see it, and Bethany don't see it. I mean, actually, you can make perceptions to try and see it, see where it went.
Bethany, you should heal up, Rod. Look around.
That's a good idea. So how many syringes do you guys have now? You were given 5 last episode, and you just used one. I think so you 4. Both used one before the fight.
Yeah.
So you should have 3 left, I believe. No, 2 left.
Yeah, I have 2 left.
Thomas, pass me a syringe real quick.
There you go.
Alright, cool. So, watch my back while I heal. So you're going to use your perception. You're going to use perception to keep an eye on everything.
I don't see nothing. I got a 3.
You're not going to see anything. And you're not going to hear anything. You just... All you see is the darkness of the early morning. And you feel the water coming down from the sky. It's not a heavy rain. It's like a light drizzle.
At least this rain feels good.
All right. Yeah, this rain feels nice.
Bethany, think we should go into Manor or just wait out here for it to return?
I don't know. What do you think? Should we make sure we kill this thing first or go see what's inside the Manor?
Well, I don't know where he went, so... He went in or he went back up?
I don't know. Let me listen real quick. So Bethany's gonna listen in. Oh, I don't hear anything.
Let's just look around this area, see if we can find anything. Find any clues.
We'll look out in front of the manor.
Yeah.
It's a good idea. So are you guys sticking together or are you gonna go to the separate sides?
Stay near, but don't go too far. You look the left side, I'll look the right side.
I'll look over here and see what I can find.
Trying to look around to see anything.
You're not looking for the monster because you already did that check a minute ago, but you are looking for any areas, what's going on around you, or what the area looks like. The story of the manor is 2 floors. You're walking around the right side, and you start to hear something, not the monster you were fighting earlier, but you see you hear something different.
Stephanie, come here for a second.
Yeah. What's up?
I hear like another animal. Not like the beast we were fighting, but something different.
You hear something else?
Yeah.
So you guys are looking around, and in front of you, you see a big gate. Not a big gate, but like a big built
awning
fence to try and block out the backyard from the front yard. It's spanning a while, and it's about... 8 feet tall, so a little taller than Bethany.
You think you can peek over this fence?
Maybe. It would take me a minute and put me at a disadvantage if the thing attacks me. But I can do it.
Don't risk it if you don't want to try it.
Maybe another time.
Yeah.
We have to keep our eyes peeled for that thing. As you guys are walking, I assume you're walking back towards the front.
Yeah.
So you're going to walk back towards the front. But as you walk back towards the front, you hear... a roaring screech, a demonic screech, not humanoid in any sense of the word. As you hear that, the noises you were hearing before, the other creatures, get louder and louder. Do you hear that, Thomas? It'd be kind of hard if you didn't. So you hear a ton of different sounds from different monsters. You hear like a from Thomas, I think we need to get inside or get cover. So as he says that, the fence you guys were just at, as well as the other one on the other side, come busting down. You both see tons of creatures. Apes, wolves, a giant scorpion, a mutated boar. All these are like, and as you look at these, they're all mutated or gigantified. And all of them are headed towards your location right now. Thomas, we need to make a move, quick!
Let's get in the house, quick!
Get in the manor! So all of these creatures are rushing your location as you guys go slam the door behind you. Thomas, lock that door! And Bethany throws his back against the wall, the door. He says, Thomas, lock the door!
Run up to it, lock it.
You run up to it, lock it. You can still hear all the noises from outside. Oh, man. Oh, that was close. What the hell are those things?
Let's just barricade the door first.
All right, look around. See what you could grab. So as he says to grab, you both look out, and I want to paint the picture for you real quick. Both of you look out in front of the door. and you can see dead marine guards. Marines all around the manor, the front of the manor. You're in the main floor, and trails of blood. There are vines, leaves, and other forest all throughout the manor, like from one side to the other. It seems like there was a battle here, but you don't know the context to. Thomas, what the hell is all this?
You said the Marines raided this place a while ago, right?
I didn't say that. It was the woman we came across. What was her name again? You said you would never forget? Don't worry, I never forget either. That woman was mighty fine. Her name was Olivia Wales. She said there was a battle here. The Marines raided this place?
Maybe the witch who supposedly lived here maybe fought them.
That's what it looks like. Let's investigate more after we grab some things. So Bethany's going up and blocking against the door because they're banging against it. Go grab those potted plants. So you see two big round plants sitting next to a fountain. Grab those plants and we can barricade this door.
Don't tell me I need a strength to pick up a plant.
To push it, yeah. The thing is, it's really big. That's why he's 16. Asking you to block the door with it. 16?
16.
Okay. So you're pushing it. You're pushing the potted plant.
All right, right here.
So you both push it against the door.
Oh, whew. I'll grab the other one.
So Bethany uses his bolsterous strength to grab the other potted plant and push it against the door. You guys are safe, so you would seem. Oh, should we look around?
Yeah, let's do that.
So as you guys are looking around, you see doors everywhere. An area to your left, you see a door. In front of you, you see a main hall with even more bodies, but you can't see the specifics of. And you just feel an overarching presence of just greenery and vines and dangerous, like, you're trying to make your way through all these vines.
I got 17.
So you're looking around?
Yeah.
So I assume you guys are going to move forward. You're both going to examine the area. And you come across a circle of just death. Bodies everywhere. In the middle, you see just this huge cage of vines. It's like, imagine a giant circle of just vines to imprison someone or to protect someone. And it's torn up. It's like it's not working anymore. All on the ground. As you approach, you see a woman laying on the ground, dead. And you know she's dead because she's got blood coming out from her body. And next to her, you see a little girl that you recognize as Sarah, laying unconscious. You don't know if she's dead or not, but she's laying unconscious next to the woman.
Let's approach Sarah.
Thomas, he reaches out and grabs you.
Is that Sarah?
Hope it's not.
So you're gonna walk towards her. You're gonna reach out, and as you what are you doing right now? You see the dead woman and an unconscious person that looks like Sarah laying next to her.
Reaching for the unconscious Sarah, possibly.
Okay, so you reach for unconscious Sarah, you're gonna turn her over, and in her hand looks like some kind of fruit with a bite taken out of it.
Don't tell me that's, Bethany goes, don't tell me that's what I think it is, Thomas.
I sure hope it's not.
So, investigating more, You try to wake up the person that looks like Sarah. You can try to roll and see if you wake her up or not.
Four.
Okay, so she's still unconscious. Bethany goes, I don't like what I'm seeing here. How did she get here?
No idea. Maybe she followed Lance, or maybe this was the other Lawrence, or whatever the other kid's name was.
Probably. It seems strange that she was able to beat us here, don't you think?
Yeah, something's fishy.
When was the last time you saw her?
There? I was back in town before we left. Almost.
That was before I went to follow you, because you didn't visit Sarah when I was with you.
No. Because we went to Granny's. We went to Granny's and neither of them were there.
Maybe she left for the maze after you left for the mines with me. But why would she come here?
Maybe she wanted to find the truth of what Granny's been hiding to her.
Granny's been hiding something. You mentioned that a few hours ago.
Yeah, when she was on the phone with some random guy, she said if she never went into the middle of that maze, the parents would still be here.
That's weird. So this woman, is this woman her mother?
No idea, but we gotta see if she's even alive.
So,
I check for a pulse?
You're checking for a pulse. And
10.
You don't find a pulse. The body feels cold, like it's been here for a while. And all the bodies you've been finding, they look like they've been there for a while. The flies are starting to get to them. Thomas, this is starting to creep me out.
Let's just try to find that key.
Let's just try to find that key, you're right.
Do you want to investigate the body? And see if the key is on it?
Yeah.
So you investigate the body, and see, you...
Ooh, perfect 20.
So, you're investigating, and you see that she's dressed like a, easily to say is Poison Ivy, but like with a lab coat and clothing. Less seductive and more like greenery. You can look into the lab coats and try and find things. As you do that, you try to see what she was holding when she died. As you find out, you actually see, like, a note. And you're gonna find the note. And it says...
Please tell certain names I love them. I'm sending my husband, Gotti. He needs to know.
What'd you find there, Thomas?
Seems like it is her mother. Here, look at this.
Alright, what is this? I don't know who will find this, but please tell Sarah and Lance I love them. Contact my husband, Gotti. He needs to know. He needs to know what?
And this, probably what she's done.
So, as you guys are listening, you hear a clashing on the top of... at the second story. Sounding like, glass breaking. Thomas, this is getting kind of fishy. I don't know about you, but I kind of want to keep living.
I know. Let's just proceed with caution and stay on the first floor.
So the two of you look to your left and to your right. There are two sets of stairs. leading up, and in front of you is an area to more doors and hallways. A hallway leading to the left and a hallway leading to the right, with a door in the middle.
Thomas, where should we go? Let's find out what's going on here.
Let's check that door.
Okay, you guys are going to walk in the door, and you see four couches and a table. If you can investigate further and try to find something if you want.
Let's check in here and see if we can find anything else.
Do you want to roll and see if you find something? Yeah. Investigation. So you find another note, and next to that note, Bethany picks up the other one.
What are these notes here? Thomas, read this one.
I've been researching a cure to this curse, as the town folk have stopped worshipping me ever since that day. I couldn't control myself and hurt people using my gift.
So I'm hoping had a devil fruit power that she called a gift. What else?
I'm hoping that with enough time and maybe some help from the curse itself, I can finally be the Amanda Quill, mother, wife, and not a goddess.
Oh, she was the goddess? Oh my god.
Well, that's who I saw when I first came to this island.
On this island, we've worshipped a goddess, but I didn't know it was her.
Ever since that day, huh? She must be referring to... Oh, snap.
Great, perhaps.
No. There was something that happened on the island, and a witch appeared. I think it was messed with. Someone must have done something to her. I don't think she would have done this by herself. The goddess I knew... She would never would have done all this. All the things that they say the witch has done?
Maybe it was someone else controlling her.
It seems like she had a devil fruit power. Those aren't very common here out in the West Blue. You say you've been to the Grand Line, you must know they're much more common over there. Let me read off this that I found. La 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 la. I was experimenting with the environment, and for some reason the wildlife around here seems to be changing. Mutating. The Marines are outside trying to bust their way into my manor. It looks like I'm trapped in here. I miss my husband, Gotti. I miss Sarah and Lance. She must have been in here for a while, huh? Thomas, I don't think she wanted to hurt anyone. Think about it. I'm not very smart myself, but look at all the bodies in here, and these notes. Maybe she was trapped in here trying to keep herself in, and the Marines out.
Maybe the Marines wanted her power for something different.
Maybe. But that fruit that Sarah was holding, was that the devil fruit that she ate? Interesting. Possibly. But what bothers me is why. Why would the Marines want in here?
Maybe there's something else in this place.
Something else here. I mean, George, the captain of the jungle pirates that we saw yesterday, he was wanting the moon key for something. He was very vague about it. But he did say at the bottom of a well. The well in town?
Maybe that's what she was protecting.
Maybe she was trying to protect the thing at the bottom of the well by keeping access out. And the Marines wanted in. Okay, this is starting to piece together. I've been on this island for a while, but I haven't heard anything about a moon or a sun key. That mayor must have been two-timing us from the beginning.
I don't like that mayor. Someone else can take this place.
So as you guys are talking, you're crashing, like a window's breaking, on the bottom floor this time.
Thomas.
This can't be good.
Oh, man. With as many monsters are out there, I'm not sure we can get ourselves out of this one. Any ideas? We don't have a lot of time here.
I'd say let's hide, but I don't know where. Do you see anywhere to hide?
We can try hiding in one of these doors. We seem to have passed a few. And this manor is huge. All right.
Let's try to hide.
So you guys are in the room with the four couches and a table right now. And you're hiding?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. I'll hide behind this couch and see what happens. So you guys are going to hide for a little while. And hide for a little while. And I say 20 minutes go by. And in that 20 minutes, you can listen in and see if you hear anything. Another perception. Both you and Bethany are going to listen in and see if anything is out there.
I got a 6.
So Bethany got a 10. Both of you don't hear much. You hear maybe the sounds of the monsters outside, but you can't tell if there's any inside.
What should we do, Thomas?
I have it there.
Right now, where's the body of Sarah? The unconscious body of Sarah. Do you have her? Like, are you carrying her?
No, we left her out there.
All right. Thomas, I don't know about leaving Sarah out there.
But if she's already dead, then the animals wouldn't really touch her.
She was unconscious when we saw her. Did you check her pulse?
I couldn't find nothing.
You couldn't find a pulse for Sarah?
Nothing.
Oh my god. Is she dead?
Hopefully not.
Okay, so you guys are talking. 5 more minutes go by. Oh man, this waiting is tearing me apart.
Can't be that bad. Would you rather be fighting something right now or hiding?
This is dangerous. We should go get Sarah.
Alright, let's see if we can do it.
Alright, watch my back. So, you and Bethany are gonna step outside of the door. As you step outside of the door, you get a better sense of your surroundings, and you can hear the monsters around you. And you can hear upstairs, and you hear downstairs, but you don't know where. As you look out in front of you, you don't see anything out of the ordinary, just all the dead bodies, and the body of Sarah and Amanda.
Let's try to quietly grab Sarah.
Alright, that's a good idea. Alright. So both of you are going to walk towards Sarah. Watch my back. So, you see, you're going to walk towards Sarah. Where are you standing right now? So, how far away are you standing from the scene? So, you stepped outside of the door, and there's about a good distance between you and the scene. Do you want to get closer or farther away from it?
I'm going to get a little closer so I can get a closer look at the surrounding area of Bethany.
Okay. So you guys are going to look around. Bethany's going to move in on Sarah. And as Bethany goes to pick up Sarah, Bethany completely gets caught off guard. And you see above Bethany is the creature you were fighting earlier, not any of the new creatures, comes out and falls right on top of Bethany. Bethany goes, "Oh shit!" So you don't have your gun, right?
Arthur still has that.
Okay, so you can try and rush towards Bethany, and we'll see if you can get there in time, or if you don't, it'll just be left up to Bethany and what Bethany can do.
Yeah, I'll try to charge it and
so you're gonna charge it and try to swing?
Perfect 20.
And you charge it just in time before it goes for the killing blow on Bethany. Just in time. Ugh! You slam your body into it. It falls onto the other bodies. So, Bethany goes, "Oh, that was a close one. I thought I was a goner. Thanks, Thomas."
He reaches out to grab your hand. You saved me once, so it's my turn to return the favor.
Now that's a man. Quick, grab Sarah. I'll deal with this thing. It's not going to catch me off guard a second time. So this thing is going to charge at Bethany. And as it charges at Bethany,
I'm trying to scrambled Sarah and the fruit.
So you're trying to grab Sarah and the fruit, and are you gonna run towards the room you were just in?
Yeah.
Okay, so as you run towards the room you were just in, you see on the left, there's a big mutated gorilla. And Bethany is currently in combat with the creature you were just slammed into. Bethany goes, he looks behind you for a quick second because he heard the big ape. Oh snap!
This can't be good, Bethany.
So you're currently, or how are you carrying Sarah? She's like a little girl.
She's over my shoulder.
Over your shoulder. And the big gorilla is starting to walk towards you. Not run, but like starting to walk towards you. What do you do? You gotta make decisions quick here.
Back up to Bethany.
So you're backing up to Bethany. You're you're back towards Bethany. And Bethany is currently engaged with the other monster. And it's like, its arms are engaged with Bethany's battle axe, and you can see up close to it if you just look behind you. And the ape is slowly starting to come in. Is there anything specific that you want to do? You want to talk to Bethany, right? Thomas, we're in trouble here.
Isn't that thing you're fighting part human?
I think so. It's not like the other ones.
Maybe we could try to connect with it.
Connect with it?
If it's human, it has to at least understand what we're saying, right?
That thing can barely be considered human. Look at it. It's currently like engaged in locked in sword v. arm scythe combat with Bethany. You look around and you see all the spider eyes and the scythe arm. You go, ugh. If you want to communicate with that thing, go for it. Be my guest. But make it quick, that ape behind you is starting to engage on us.
We're not here to fight you, we just need something from this maze and we'll leave you alone. Can you help us?
So it slices against Bethany, but Bethany blocks it with the battle axe and backs up. You can tell that it's trying to say something, but it's just all it can get out is the word I. The gorilla is very close to you now. It's almost within striking distance.
Bethany, do you have any idea what to do right now?
That's a good idea, Thomas. I don't know what to do. So as you guys are standing here, you hear
Woo! What was that, Bethany?
What was that? It sounded like it came from upstairs. So as you guys are fighting this thing, as Bethany's fighting this thing and it backed up, the gorilla is starting to gain on you. You see from upstairs, it comes dropping down. On top of the gorilla is Zane with two swords stabbing into the gorilla. I got Zane. You guys, don't worry!
Zane, you crazy bastard.
Zane, what the hell? Wasn't he supposed to be fighting some kind of Cerberus?
How'd that go, Zane?
Zane's currently being swung left and right on the gorilla. I followed it here! After... He can't exactly tell you the whole story. I'll tell you more after. Whoa! So he pulls the two swords out of the gorilla. So currently, the gorilla is swinging left and right, swinging Zane left and right. He's holding on to his two swords on the back of the gorilla. And Bethany has got his eye on the monster you guys were fighting.
I got an 11.
11. Okay, you're gonna go after the gorilla. So the gorilla. Does its little beating its chest. So it's gonna use its big fist to try and swing at Zane. It's gonna swing at Zane using its big fist, and it hits Zane right in the chest. Ugh. Ah. Zane is critically hit by this. Ugh! Zane's against the wall, being beaten by the gorilla. Bethany's dealing with the monster behind you.
Bethany, I'm gonna go help Zane real quick.
So, you still have Sarah in your arms. What do you want to do there? You're gonna set her on the ground real quick and then charge at the gorilla. Now the gorilla gets a chance to deal with this attack because you had to set the girl down. So, if you describe to me what you're doing here. You're running at it, and you have a katana.
I'm going to take out the katana and... You know how they do in, like, Samurai Jack, how he'll jump and try to, like, slice the top of the head?
You're going to jump and slice at the top of the head?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, as you jump and take a swing at the top of the head, he's going to have to make a DC save. A saving throw for the gorilla. It's really good. Oh, man. So, as it sees you coming, grabs you by the arm in midair, and punches you right in the face. Ooh.
Take it like a champ.
Take it like a champ. Okay. It's going to deal 19 damage right to your face.
Man.
So how much HP are you at?
45.
You're at 45. So you're less than half HP. So you're bloodied. That's bad. Okay.
Yes.
So it's going to hit you right in the face. You're going to go flying. You're going to go to the other side of the room. But that gives Zane time to get up. Thomas, I don't know what you're... Ugh! So it... The monster attacks Bethany, and he's going to use a reaction. And the creature misses. You're against the wall. Zane's against the wall. The gorilla just hit you. Bethany dodges the attack from the monster, using its action to gain some distance from it. And in doing that, the creature uses its turn to back up. The gorilla's gonna go back to attacking Zane. And as Zane is doing that, is trying to deal with the gorilla, he's actually trying to get up and get out of the way, but he's taking a lot of damage. Now, he's gonna actually have to take a save here. So he does just enough to roll. He rolls! Gets out of the way from the big fist this time. He's still bloodied. He's trying to deal. He took 40 damage last round. Now, he goes, we're in trouble, guys. So you guys are in combat, so it's kind of hard to have a conversation, but he does get that enough out. He's like, we're in trouble. Bethany, how are you doing? You're against the wall, and Bethany's dealing with the officer that you got. You can tell it was an officer because he had the coattails. It was a low-ranking officer from having looking at the coat.
Oh, snap, guys. I don't know how I'm dealing with... Any ideas?
Thomas, you're getting up. You're trying to find your footing. If you want to say anything, now's the time.
I think killed one of them.
Did you say we should focus our fire?
Exactly.
Let's get this gorilla out of the way. I'll hold on to this. You guys both attack the gorilla.
Zane goes, all right. Whew. Thomas, let's do this.
First, let me take something real quick. I'm going to take my steroids.
Okay. That's a plus 10% damage. You pop it into you. It's an actual syringe this time, not like a, it's a different syringe. We'll just say different. Different syringe. You pop it into you, and you feel stronger for some reason. Ugh. Ooh.
This is Zane.
Let's do this. I mean, let's go. Let's go.
So the two of you are going to run at it at the same time. So, this girl is basically at full HP, minus the damage it took from Zane. Zane's gonna go,
slash at its feet! I'll grab its other feet!
So, Zane grabs both of his swords, takes a slice at the legs. You're gonna, take a slice at the other leg. So we'll roll here, see if you get it.
I got a 7.
Boom. It's okay, because you're doing a team attack, so you get an advantage.
I'll bet.
So you roll both and see whatever's higher. Whatever's higher you use. Yeet. So both of you, you're going to critically hit this thing, slicing at its legs. So it, you didn't critically kill it. What you did was critically stun it. So it misses its next turn.
I do damage.
Oh, that was a crit to hit it. Okay, yeah, damage. Now you roll how much damage you did to it.
34.
So plus 10% of that. So it'd be like 37 damage. Huge amount of damage to it. Zane goes, nice! He goes up for a high five. Now both of you are going to go in for the attack on the gorilla at the same time, because it skipped its next turn. You slice its head off together, killing it in one foul swoop.
One down. That's one down. To go.
Bethany's one to go. Fighting the thing. So while you guys are doing this, Bethany's fighting the monster over there. Ugh, this thing is tough. But if they can handle that, I can handle this. Come here, you monster. Bethany's walking really angrily towards it, but it's too fast. It dodges out of the way from an attack, goes in and uses an attack, stealth slash. Now, what's happening is that it's moving so fast that Bethany can't see it. It's like moving back and forth too quickly. Ugh! This thing ain't gonna kill me today. Ugh. So Bethany takes all that damage. Bethany's really low. Bethany goes, I'm not dying today. He takes that hit in stride. He uses it to actually go in and attack the monster. Because Bethany is a trad. So he takes the damage from the scythe thing, but he grabs the scythe. He takes a little bit more damage. However, he's going to take a d5. Roll 1d6. We'll say d6. So Bethany takes 3 more damage. However, having taken the 3 more damage, he can grab the scythe things that's sticking into him and swing with advantage. So Bethany is going to swing at this thing and hit it right in the face. Not with an axe, but with his fists. Critically hitting it right in the gut. Now this thing is really low, and it actually recognizes this and backs up a lot. It uses its next turn to back up all the way. You guys can't see it anymore.
So any backup means Zane will take care of the rest.
Thanks, guys. I don't think I can take much more.
Use the last syringe.
Alright. So you guys take up front. You move up front, in front of Bethany. Bethany backs up away from you and is healing. You guys can't see the monster anymore.
I'll do a perception check.
Yeah, roll for perception. See if you see it.
11.
11. So you can't see it, but you do still hear it. You hear the... Zane's actually really low next to you as well, because he took the critical hit from the gorilla. Thomas, even if we kill this thing, we're still gonna have to deal with all the other ones, aren't we?
Right now, let's just deal with this one.
Oh man, I didn't want to die today.
No one's dying on my watch.
So you guys can't see it, but you do hear it.
And I examined the fruit Sarah ate. Mm-hmm. Routine. I'm gonna look at the fruit.
Okay, so looking at the fruit, you see it's green with swirls all over it, and the swirls seem to have spikes sticking out. And turning it over, you can see a bite was taken out of it.
Does seem like a double fruit, but if she was dead, I think they would regrow somewhere else, so she can't be dead right now. We have to try to wake up Sarah, guys.
Bethany goes, wake up Sarah? Why would we do that?
She has a double fruit. She may be able to help us out.
That's a double fruit?
99% sure, Bethany. No other fruit looks like this.
What is this double fruit thing you guys keep talking about?
I'll explain later, Zane.
Zane goes, it's a good thing Daniel left me.
What did he leave you?
He led me towards some kind of dead end, and when I turned around, he was gone. He didn't lead me to the Cerberus, but he didn't take me any money. He didn't take my money either. It was weird. It was like Daniel was running from something.
Or to something. Wasn't there water around here?
Yeah, when you came in, you saw water by the front.
That's amazing. You can go drown Sarah to wake her up.
I'm not drowning a child, Thomas. What the hell do you think take me for?
Just wake her up somehow.
You mean splash some water on her face? Alright, I can do that.
Bethany's gonna take the unconscious Sarah. He's gonna walk over. Walk over to the little tub, the fountain. And he's gonna sit her down in it and splash some water onto Sarah's face.
What's going on? Where am I? I feel weak. Why do I feel weak?
Don't worry. I got you. I don't know why you're here, but I got you.
Bethany's gonna grab Sarah and bring her over to you.
Guys, I think we woke her up.
How'd you get here?
Where is here? I don't know what you're talking about.
How'd you get to the middle of the maze before me?
Fine. Grandma was talking about my mother on the phone. And she can lie all she wants, but I know it's her. And I had to come and find out for myself.
I didn't
want it to be true. What I ate.
Yes, this holds up the fruit.
I was in this maze for so long, I was so hungry.
You possibly ate a devil fruit.
A what?
You may have powers beyond our strength right now.
I don't know what you're talking about, Thomas.
Lie to me, Sarah.
That's true. I haven't heard of this devil fruit thing.
Oh, guys. I think the thing is coming back for us. It's coming back for round two.
Go hide, Sarah. We gotta deal with this thing first.
Okay.
So, Sarah's gonna get back on her feet. She's gonna run towards the, she's gonna run towards the door. So the three of you are looking around for the thing while Sarah runs towards the room. And as she runs towards the room, you can see, it fall onto the ground next to Sarah. And Sarah turns around and she screams, but as she screams, a lot of the vines around the room turn and start moving towards her location at the monster at the same time and impale it. And Sarah's on the ground in the fetal position with her eyes closed.
Hey guys, was that?
She has a devil fruit, I knew it. Sarah, you did it.
What?
She opens her eyes, she's looking at you guys.
You beat the monster.
I beat the monster?
Look.
Alright. That was weird, but okay. Not too weird. I haven't seen anything like that in a while.
But let's just make sure that we kill this thing once and for all.
So you're gonna walk up to it. It's not dead, but it's 1 HP. It had sturdy.
Pull out my katana. And go for the throat.
So, describe to me what you're doing. The finishing blow, go for it.
Pull out katana, put it against her, and try to speak to it again. How did you get here?
I
did this to you.
It's all it's saying is I.
I think you're a waste of my time. I'm gonna chop this head off.
You can chop its head off. The head goes onto the floor.
Okay, well that's one problem solved. Oh man. This was tough.
At least we came out alive.
At least we're alive. But all those monsters out there are still... Wait. Do you think these monsters were created or controlled by Sarah's mother?
I think she made them to try to protect this area. We gotta look for that.
It kind of went out haywire, didn't it? These things want to kill us.
Because they think we're gonna go hurt something in this place. Let's just look around to see what we can find.
I don't know what's going on.
Zane goes... Alright. I'll go look upstairs. Bethany, you want to come with me?
Yeah, alright.
I'll stay in here and see what I can find.
I'll stay with you.
So Sarah's staying with you. Bethany and Zane go upstairs.
Oh man.
I want to inspect the creature.
So you're inspecting the creature. And you can see...
I got a 17 on what I could find.
So it's wearing jeans. And it's like a... It's like a marine jeans and the marine cloak with the hood and spider eyes, as well as like a some kind of lizard tongue.
Thing's one ugly motherfucker.
So if you wanted to see something on it, that was your roll. 17. Okay, so you rolled to see what was on it. So
yeah.
You can reach into the coat tail pocket, and you're going to pull out a note. And on the note, it says, "From Vice Admiral Coy to Ensign Marine Jonathan. Eliminate the user of the Shokusei Shokusen no Mi, and take the fruit. Bring it back to base, Von Torque. I'd want to see this fruit in your hands by the end of winter."
That can't be good. And what's the devil fruit, English?
It would be the vegetation.
So the veggie fruit.
The veggie fruit, yeah. Veggie makes it sound like you're about to eat some vegetables.
I mean, ideally she can control plants. I look at the note.
You look at the note.
Read that. Now let's head to one of the... You said there's two doors or two hallways? Zane and Bethany went upstairs.
Zane and Bethany went upstairs, so you saw the door, and then there's a hallway to the left and a hallway to the right. The hallway to the left is the way that the gorilla came.
Let's head down the hallway to the right.
So you're heading down to the hallway to the right, and on your left you see a door, and you hit the wall, and you can take a right or take the door to the left.
Let's take the door to the left.
So taking the door to the left, you see inside there's a small fountain. Smaller than the one at the front, a couch, and a TV stand, as well as a curtain leading to another area.
Let's head to the curtain area.
So in the curtain area, you see a bed and a table. You can investigate to see if you find something here.
Yeah. We type that thing.
So let's see if you find anything. Cool. So looking around, you see on the table, you see it's a syringe with caffeine written on it.
Caffeine shot.
Mm-hmm.
Take it.
Okay. So in the terms of D&D, you can take a caffeine shot to speed you up, to move quicker.
Big bet.
Same as the other ones you use as a bonus action. So, what are you doing? You would still, you found that, and that's...
Is that the only thing I found?
Yes.
Let's head back to...
Leave this area? Okay, so you open the door, and you're back in the hallway you were just in.
Now there's something straight of me?
You can head straight, or you can head back to the right.
Let's head straight.
You can head straight, and you see there's lanterns, or lights, some kind of plant creature lighting up the area all around you. In the top of the ceilings, there's these glowing plant lanterns. So you reach the end of the hallway, and to the left is a doorway. And
let's take the door.
So you're going to take the doorway, and taking the doorway, you see three pillows sitting on the floor in a big circle arrangement, with two doors leading to the left, one door leading to the right, and a small fountain behind the three pillows.
Let's investigate the fountain.
You want to investigate the fountain, see what you can find, see if you find anything.
A nine.
So you don't find anything, it looks like a normal fountain to you.
Let's take the right door.
So you're taking the right door. You head out and you see a big garden area. A big garden area. There's a big fountain in the middle. A smaller fountain towards the front. And three shrubs around the area.
Let's look around this area.
So you're walking around the garden area and you see vegetables growing, you see fruits growing, you see all types of greenery. Things that you assume she was living off of. She had her own garden.
Let's look at the fruits and see what I can see what they are.
Okay, I know what you're after. Just roll to see how lucky you are. If you can roll a 20, we'll see. Oh, you already rolled for this?
Yeah, I rolled an 8.
Okay, so you didn't see anything special. You see oranges, apples, cucumbers, all types of fruit. None that look any sorts of suspicious.
Alright, let's head out of this room and head to the left door.
Okay, so you head back into the three pillows room and you head to there's two doors. You can head inside one of them and you see there's a bed and a counter. There's a bed and a table.
You already know what I'm finna do. See if I can see anything.
We look at everything.
I don't see shit.
You don't see anything. So you're gonna head out and look in the other room. It's the same identical as the room you were just in.
8 on that one.
So you don't find anything special. You just see like normal guest room things, like a toothbrush, toothpaste, combs, the type of daily routine things.
Head
back out to the main hall.
Head back out to the main hall, and instead of taking the right hallway, we're going to take the left.
Okay, you take the left hallway. Moving straight, you see there's a small door to your right, and a double doors in front of you, and a hallway to your left.
What happened? I didn't close the wrong application.
You closed the wrong application?
Yeah, I went to close the calculator instead of Discord, but I closed Discord. So I went to the left hallway, and what do I see?
You see a small door on the right, you see a double doors in front of you, and another hallway to your left.
Take the small right door.
You see the small right door, and you're in a small hallway. If you put your arms out, you would touch both walls. You see four doors, really small doors, one directly in front of you, a few feet ahead, about 10 feet ahead, two doors to your right, and one door to your left.
take the door on the left.
You take the door on the left, and you see you're in some sort of sauna area. There are benches and a steam vent. You can investigate this area. See how good it is.
Five.
Okay. You see some sort of glint in the right side of the room. Walking over to it, you pick it up and see it's a sour candy. The same as before.
Another piece of candy.
Mm-hmm. So there's another door to your left leading to a different area. Presumably the area with the double doors that you were just looking at a minute ago.
Yeah.
And you walk through it and you see four pillars and a star pentagram on the bottom, with three smaller fountains on the right and a curtain in front.
Sarah, help me look around this room.
Sarah, with you?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So Sarah's walking around the room with you. It's like, man, my mom was weird. Whoa. She's looking and she's in awe. I miss her, though.
No, but let's just get out of this place. But let's look around first.
You find some sort of another candy. This time it's a sweet candy. You find a sweet candy. Player buff. So, sour candy reduce incoming damage by 10%. No. Sweet candy reduce damage coming in. Sour candy increase damage going out. So you just found a sweet candy. When you pop it, it reduces your incoming damage by 10%. Sour candy increased by 10%. Cool. Just letting you know what they do. Oh.
Sweet decrease damage?
Sweet decreases the incoming damage. Like if you're about to take a big hit.
And sour does the opposite.
Mm-hmm. Cool. So you found two pieces of candy. My mom definitely had a sweet tooth then, I see. I didn't know too much about her. I got to see her a few times, but my grandma didn't like that I did. You guys are walking around. You inspected the area, and you found another piece of candy. What do you want to do?
Go to smash out the double doors and go to the doors on the right.
Okay, so you go to the double doors. Okay, so you go through the double doors, and you see you're in the hallway you were just in a few minutes ago. You can head to the right, or head back into the little area to the left. Or head straight and go back to the main hall.
Go to the two smaller doors that I haven't gone through yet.
So you go through, and you go through the door on the left, and then you take a door on the right, and you see there's cargo and things everywhere.
Inspection.
On the right and left. You want to inspect?
I am blind.
You are blind tonight. Yeesh. So you don't see anything. You just see barrels and, like, cloth.
Sarah, do you see anything?
No, it's too cramped in here.
Alright, let's get out of this one then.
And you go into the other one. It's almost the same exact thing. Identical.
Am I blind? I'm not blind.
You're not blind this time. And you find... No. Find, ooh, okay, so you haven't found this yet in the campaign, which is cool. Let's, remind me what this is. This is a common, so we'll go here. So you found a recipe for pancakes.
Nice.
You can inventory that, and that'll come up later.
Let's head back to the main hall.
Okay, so you head back out. You open the door and head to the left. And you open the door, and now you're at the double doors to your right. Hallway to straight, and the main hall to the left.
Main hall to the left.
Okay, head out and go to the main hall on the left. And you head to the right, and now you're out in the main hall where everything was.
Head upstairs.
You're gonna head upstairs. So as you head upstairs, you see there are two stairways, one on the right and one on the left.
The one on the left.
Take the one on the left. So you circle around, and two stairways lead to the same place. So as you see two hallways, one to your left, one to your right, three doors, one door to the right, three doors to the left, and a door in front of you. You're in a big manor.
Well, I have two hallways and four doors to choose from.
Six doors.
Hallways.
There are two hallways. So you walked up the stairs. You see a door smack dab right in front of you. You see, you can turn to your right and see two doors down, and turn to your left and see three doors down.
Left or right hall. Let's go in the door in front of me.
You walk straight into the door right in front of you, and you see benches in a few different places, and torches. Two torches at the door's entrance, and four benches.
Investigation check.
Investigate.
I'm blind.
You're blind. Six. So you can't find anything. I just wanted to know what happened to my mom. But when I got here, she was dead.
I've been dead for a while.
You know why she was holding that fruit?
She wanted to keep it away from the Marines.
So you and Sarah are upstairs, and you walk inside this room. There are two torches on the right, and two torches torch to your left and torch to your right. A bunch of benches.
I did my investigation check in here.
You did your investigation check, and you're gonna find nothing because you didn't get much.
Alright, let's walk out these doors and head
left
to the left hallway with the
left
two doors.
With the two doors. So you can take the door on the left or take the door on the right.
Just take the door on the left.
Take the door on the left. You see inside there are two couches, a small fountain, and a rug on the floor.
I'm checking every room possible.
Check every room possible. I got loot. We'll see if you get this one. So this is a 17. Good roll. So you found an item, and it's like it's a pill. We'll say it's a pill this time. On it says weak revival. Now, in DM terms, this is an item that you can use when anyone but you go unconscious. When a character goes to zero hit points, they go unconscious, they don't die. And they have to make a check every turn to see if they wake up. Now with Reek Revival, you can use it on someone to have them immediately wake up.
Alright. Let's head out this door and head to the right door.
Okay. Head to the door on the right, and you see a big bed in the middle, and a few plants and a small fountain to the left.
You already know. I'm blind.
You don't.
I am blind tonight.
At least okay, combat so you see two doors on the right. Presumably, one door is the bathroom, and one door is the some kind of changing room.
A closet.
So you want a closet? One door is a closet, and the other is a bathroom.
Let's head into the closet.
You head in the closet, and you look around.
I got a 9. A little bit better.
Almost better. You still don't see anything.
Fuck.
Okay.
Bathroom.
So you head into the bathroom. This is just you rolling perceptions all day now. Yeah. Nothing. You don't see anything. Man, these rolls are not great for you, dude.
Let's head to the other hallway.
Okay, so you're gonna head to the other hallway. There are 3 doors, 2 to your left and 1 to your right. First door to your left.
Go on the door in the middle. Right?
So you're gonna head to a door in the middle. And in the door in the middle, there are 2 couches with another door on the right.
Let's inspect that couch.
Inspect this area. What'd you get?
12.
Okay, so you look around and you see on the table in the middle, there are 3 bottles of Ramune. Ramune give you thirst quench. You can put those in your inventory.
So they're just called like water.
It's basically water. It's just Japanese water.
Oh, I got 3 of them.
Nice.
What?
Nice. You got 3, you can add your inventory.
And you said there was a door in this room?
Yeah, door to the right.
Head in the door on the right.
Head to the door on the right, you see a bed and a table.
You already know what's poppin'. Please don't make me blind. I'm blind.
Blind. Okay. Right. Okay, nothing.
Let's walk out this room and head.
Same time, I'll just tell you what you need to roll. If you need to roll higher than 10. If you roll higher than 10, you find something.
Okay.
Okay.
Alright, head out this door, back to the couch room, out of that door, to the left door.
To the left door? So, inside the door, you see 3 couches, a table, Bethany sitting with his feet up, and Zane also with his feet up on the other couch.
Hey, Thomas! I'm sorry I'm not looking around as much. We're just tired. I'm trying to get some rest in.
That's fine. Susan, can you stay here?
Yeah. We can never stay here.
Okay.
Did you find anything in this room, or did y'all just come in here and relax?
Oh yeah, we're relaxing. But we also found a few Phoenix kits. There's only 2. So, me and Zane already used them up. Sorry about that. We found 2 Phoenix kits, but we used them up already, Thomas. Sorry about that.
It's fine. Anything else in this room?
Not that I can see. You see anything, Zane?
Zane's like half asleep.
Huh? Yeah. Yeah, I'm awake. I am very awake. What are we doing?
Is there anything in this room that y'all haven't found yet?
Yeah, me and Zane patched ourselves up. Me and Bethany patched ourselves up a little bit, and now we're taking some Jedi.
Okay.
There's a... You look behind the 3 couches and you see there's a door.
We're gonna walk through that door.
Walk through that door. You see 4 beds all around.
Do it again. I got an 11. Yes.
Okay, so you look and you see a long sword up against the wall. there's a sword just laying there.
Is it a big sword or a smaller sword?
It's a long sword.
I'm gonna take it.
It's longer than your katana. It has its advantages and disadvantages.
I'm gonna just put it on my back.
You're gonna set it on your back. So I'd say, what is your inventory right now? Say you've got
pack of smokes, the lighter, sweet candy, sour candy, the lantern, a bullet, three and a half things of food, caffeine shot, pancake recipe, weak revival, three water, and now I have a sword.
There's no doors in this room except the one you just walked in through. You found a long sword. So this long sword, we'll say, has plus 8 to hit, but it has a reduction to damage. Minus d4. We'll say minus 4 to damage, but plus 8 to hit.
Yeah. We're not going to use it. So let's head back to the room where Bethany's at.
Okay. Hey, good to see you again.
How much should I get for this from yourself?
Oh, it's a nice sword. Looks like a long sword from the year 1022. It's like a good aged one. Wonder what it's doing here. Oh, you asked for the price? I could probably do 40,000 betty for it. How does that sound?
We'll talk when we get back to the shop.
Alright.
So for right now, you can watch this.
So you set it on the table. Set the long sword on the table.
Let's walk out that door and head to the right door.
Okay, so you head out and head to the door on the left, which is the right door, basically.
Yeah.
And as you walk in the door, you see three more pillows on the ground and a potted plant in the right corner.
Don't need to worry about it because I'm blind. Alright. What else is there for me to look?
You see another door past that that you can go through? Take another shot at the perception. You're gonna walk through the store and you see just a bed and a table.
I'm blind.
You're still blind. This is fun, just watching you fail at the perception.
Me being blind.
So, there's no doors in this room, it's just a small room with a bed and a table.
Bethany.
You're gonna go back to Bethany.
Or isn't there another side of staircase?
Both staircases lead to the same place.
Okay, so it's just like a normal mansion staircase area. Okay.
Think Resident Evil.
But there would be doors on the other side.
Did you go through those doors yet?
I only went up the left side and we're on the left side of the staircase. So if I take little catwalk to the right side, let's head back out to the hallway upstairs and see what's on the right side of the mansion. Okay.
So you have been in the door on the right, and on the left is an area you haven't been in yet.
Well, let's go in there then.
You're gonna go through there. You're gonna see two couches, a rug. You have been in this room actually, because I remember describing this to you. So you're gonna walk in here and be like, this looks familiar.
Walk back out.
Okay. Now you're back out in the long hallway.
I said back to the main hall.
Main hallway. Okay, so you walk downstairs. You're out in the main hallway now.
I'm trying to think to myself, where would they hide the fucking...
Uh, Exploration, that's also a big part of D&D.
What's up the right staircase?
They both head to the same area.
So no matter what, I'm going to that left side with the three doors and whatnot.
So, in the main hall, there are two stairwells. One to the left, curving up, and the other one curving up. One curves to the left, one curves to the right. They both head to the area that you were just at.
Is there anything downstairs that I haven't been through?
We'll just keep looking.
I already been to the hallway where me and Bethany first came in. I've already been on that side. That's the right side. Is there anything on the left side of the mansion?
So you're gonna head, where are you gonna go?
Where's the left side, not upstairs, but downstairs?
So you're downstairs. You can head back to the left side of the mansion. So you're walking and you see the double doors in front of you, the small door to your right, and a long hallway leading left.
I've already been through all of that.
Have you?
Let's head to the left.
So you walk down the long hallway. You still see those glowing little plant lanterns things. And you see a doorway at the end of the hallway.
Head to the doorway.
Head through the doorway. You see a big room. This looks like the dining room area. Along with that, you see a small a small staircase to your left, and a big dining room area with no doors leading anywhere.
In a smaller dining room right now?
Right now you're in like a dining room area, and there's a small staircase leading to the left on the right, on the left side.
Let's take the smaller staircase to the left.
Staircase to the left, and you're in some big storage room. There are just boxes and crates everywhere.
What have you been here?
Huh?
I think I already been here, but fuck it, I'ma search it.
Let's see if you find anything in this area.
I'm legally blind.
Oh my god. So, not only do you not find anything,
hey. I stub my toe.
That's funny. You stub your toe, take 1 point of damage.
Well, you're an ass for that.
I just think that's hilarious. Oh my god.
Now, instead of being at 45 health, I'm at 44 health.
You rolled a 1. I gotta punish you somehow. Alright.
Alright, let's head back up the smaller staircase and head to the bigger dining room.
Okay, so you head to the dining room, and in this dining room there are three tables and some kind of stove area, along with some tables and a kitchen area. Dun, 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 dun. Get those explorer pants on. 20! So, you see... in this area, on the tables are some syringes, and these syringes are health syringes. They're not special. They will heal you if used.
How many?
There are 5. So 15 times 5. That's how much HP you can heal. It'll take you a good minute.
75 points of health.
Heal for 75. That would put you up to full.
It put me up above health, full.
Above full. Well, you can only heal to full.
Perfect.
Nice.
Okay. I'm gonna use 3 of them.
Okay, so you're gonna use 3 healing for 45.
4,500 plus at 89.
Some people are like, I don't like this part of D&D. Nothing happens, but I like this part of D&D because it like shows the exploration side, because there's so many, like, fighting side and, like, roll for damage and initiative, but to me it's like, I like to explore.
Yeah, well, now I'm back to 89 health. Hopefully I don't stub my toe again.
88. Okay. So, you're back in the... You're in the cafeteria area. The dining room area, actually. Yeah.
Big one or the smaller one?
There's only one. It was slightly confusing, but it was only one area. Dining room area.
Well, let's just head back up, head back, to Bethany and them.
So you're gonna head back to Bethany. So, you head back to Bethany.
Hey! Ah, good to see you. Did you find anything fun?
It's not gonna be something else.
Oh, okay, that's good. We're all feeling a little bit better.
Now we just sort of find the key.
Oh, that's good. We still haven't found this key, and how long has it been since George told us to find the key?
So, you're thinking now, and you think it's been about 12, 13 hours.
Roughly 15 hours. I don't want to be exact with that, but it's been a while. If we don't find this key fast, we're going to get...
No wonder
someone's going to die.
If we don't find this key in the next 8 hours, people are going to die.
So let's find this key and get out of here. Then we can go sleep.
But you said you've lurked everywhere. Where would this thing be?
We haven't checked the backyard.
That's a good question. That's a good idea. Is Zane still sleeping?
Huh? What? Oh, we're
going
leaving?
To the backyard.
Are we leaving yet?
Well, yes.
Alright. Alright, let's go. So you guys, do you know the way to the backyard?
Nope.
Yeah.
Thomas, you looked at the first floor, right? We checked the second floor. You know where... The way to the back room is?
No, I didn't think we'd get this far, actually.
that's okay. Let's go downstairs and see if we can find it. So the three of you head downstairs.
Four of us.
Four. The four of you head downstairs. So, heading out. The four of you are standing in the main hall, and Bethany walks towards the main area, so... what if we all take a different door and look? And try to find this area. This, back door.
Or we can try to bust down the gate.
Oh, true. That is...
Didn't the animals bust down the gate?
They did. Do you think they're still out there?
Yeah, when, guys, I came after you guys got here, and I was chasing the Cerberus. After Daniel left me, I was trying to make my way out of the maze, but I got lost. And I came across some monsters running, and they ignored me, so I followed them. And I followed them all the way here. And when I got here, you guys... were running inside of the manor, and I didn't know what to do. None of the monsters were bugging me, so I thought it'd be a good idea to try and help you guys out. And I climbed on top of the manor from the left side. And when I climbed to the top of the manor, I could see all the monsters. There's a lot of them, guys. Not too many we couldn't kill, but there's definitely a lot.
Okay,
Well, now we have a devil fruit user, so...
Are you talking about Sarah? You really want to send her to the front lines with us?
No, but if it has to.
Okay. I don't think she can control her power too much. You saw what happened with that monster we fought. She screamed and was cowering.
But she killed it, didn't she?
That was just luck. At least the way I see it. What about you, Sarah? Why don't you just tell us?
I don't know what happened. It was coming at me, so I was too scared.
See? She didn't even mean to kill it.
I killed something?
No, dear. No, dear. She definitely did kill it.
Hey, Bethany, I heard that.
Well, let's just head to the top of this manor and see what we can find.
So, Zane goes, I broke in through a window on the top floor, on the second floor. Do you want to go through that window?
Let's do it.
So the four of you head out to the second floor, and you head out to left past the area you guys were chilling in, and you see a window that Zane broke through. And looking out of the window, you can see all the monsters on the ground making a bunch of noise. Just a bunch of mutated noises and things.
Pass anything that looks suspicious, Zane? Like another door or a secret... Passageway.
I didn't seem to see anything. No, wait.
I didn't see anything that came by. I climbed on top, but there was a backyard area. Do you think we can climb on top of the building again and try to see?
Let's do it.
You guys are gonna climb. You're gonna try and roll. I'm gonna roll for three, and you're gonna roll for yourself to see if you fall.
I fall.
Jeez, your rolls hate you today. Let's see who falls. Let's see.
Not gonna get above a 10 to stay on the roof.
Essentially, it's like the average. At 10, above 10 is just the average. Unless something is more difficult or less difficult. Meaning, like, yep. If you had climber gear, it would be a 5, above a 5. If you were carrying someone, like Luffy carried Sanji and Nami when climbing up that would be even more difficult, and you'd have to be above a 15. It's just the things that happen and the circumstances affect your role. Since nothing is changed, it'd be above a 10.
Alright, well, I got a 7.
Okay. So, let's see.
We all fall.
Everyone except for Bethany falls. Okay. Guys, where are you going? And Zane goes, ugh! I wasn't trying to fall. Zara goes, ow! So, you guys are going to fall from the second story, so obviously you're taking damage, but all of you are going to take 1d. All of you take 6 damage for falling off of a second story building. And what's worse is that you are now surrounded by things. You're now surrounded by monsters.
Well...
Okay, so let me explain to you what is surrounding you right now. You're surrounded by a mutated lion, a giant spider, a mutated wolf, a giant scorpion, a giant beetle, giant rat, giant centipede, a Cerberus, the one Zane was chasing, and a boar, a mutated boar. So imagine all those creatures surrounding you guys. Ugh! So there are bushes all around the area, so you can try and hide before they see you, which would probably be recommended.
So going to roll.
Well, first you want to talk. This is a role-playing game.
Yeah,
Bethany's on the second floor. He's on the ceiling. On the roof. Sarah goes, "Oh my god, I'm so scared." Zane goes, "Shh, shh, shh. I don't think they've seen us yet. Thomas, what do you think we should do?"
Hide in the bushes. Hide in the bushes.
Okay, that's a good idea. So we're gonna hide.
Bitch.
So you guys are gonna hide. That was your roll. We're gonna roll for. Okay, so Sarah hides successfully, but you and Zane try to hide, but are seen by the rat and the boar. So the rat and the boar start to move towards you.
Destiny, go get the head, maybe they'll recognize it.
What kind of idea is that? Also, I can barely hear you from all the way down there.
Maybe they will intimidate them and won't fight us.
I thought I was loud.
So since you yelled, since you're yelling, the giant centipede is also sees you. And is moving toward you. So the rat, the boar, and the centipede are all moving towards your direction.
You know what I'm saying? Now that I'm thinking about it, that was probably a bad idea.
Thomas, now I'm starting to think this was a bad idea. What gave you that impression?
You don't say.
So as you guys are attempting to hide, those three monsters are moving towards you. They haven't started combat yet. They're just on your way. So I would recommend. Wait, I'm the DM. Thomas, I would recommend us to run. Doesn't look good.
Free run, they will all start chasing us.
Either that or we start fighting.
Arrow, do you think you can try to make a plant wall or something?
I don't know.
Try something while we think of something.
Okay. Sarah's trying to use her ability. Let's see if she can control her powers. So she's under a lot of stress right now. Holy sh! Okay. Sarah's gonna go, So as she's attempting to use her power, all the creatures stop moving. Just stop moving. That's your cue.
I'm saying, do you think we should chop all their heads off or make a break for it?
I don't know how long she's gonna hold them off for. Also, do you think it's kind of weird? Anyway, we don't have time for this. You said this was like a devil fruit power?
Yeah.
I've never seen this before.
Let's just run.
Okay, I'll grab the girl. So Zane grabs Sarah. She loses her concentration, but you guys get a head start, and you're running towards. Where?
Front.
The front? Okay, you head towards the front. And you make your way back towards the front, past a bunch of monsters. And what do?
Run inside.
So you try to run inside, but the door is jammed. Wonder why is that? God. You can't seem to go inside. The monsters are starting to move towards your location. You gotta think fast.
Jump through the window.
You can break the window? Okay. Let me see if there's any windows you can break. Like, luckily, you've got one window on the right. It's small. I don't know if you and Zane would be able to fit. I don't know if we'd be able to fit through that.
Break it and send them Sarah and have Sarah go get Bethany.
It's a good idea. Okay. So Zane uses swords. The back of his swords uses the blunt damage to try and break the, break the glass.
Now he breaks the glass. Gah! Okay, Sarah, go through.
Oh,
this is starting to get... She's starting to get really stressed.
You'll be okay. I promise.
Okay.
So, Sarah goes through. And the two of you are now one move away from all of the monsters getting onto you. They're turning the corner now.
Lane, do you have any ideas?
Run? I think we should run.
Yeah, that sounds like a good backyard. Point. Sounds like a good idea.
Okay, the two of you run. You're running towards the backyard. And when you reach the backyard, you see... the back door, finally. And two monsters that are lagged behind. It's the scorpion and the spider. So they're blocking your path to the back door.
What do you do? Reactions. What do we do? Do we run in a circle?
I can distract them while you get inside. Don't worry about me.
Sure. You say? Don't you fucking die on me.
Okay. You grab Zane, gives him a good handshake, just like when you first met. So, Zane, hey, over here! Zane grabs and rocks on the ground, throws him at the giant scorpion and the spider. I'm over here! So he only, let's see if he manages to get both of their attention. He manages to get both of their attention, and they're both rushing at Zane now. What do you do?
Run to the back door.
So you're running to the back door, and you open the back door, and you're finally inside. You have no idea what happened to Zane, if he's doing all right, but you are now inside. Looking in the hallway, it looks familiar. You've been in this hallway before.
Bethany!
I can hear you! Where are you?
Downstairs, back door!
I'm on my way!
Bethany!
So you head downstairs? Bethany heads downstairs.
Is there a window I could peek out of?
Nope. You're in remember the hallway I told you about? That was two... You reach your arms out, you touching both walls. There are no windows in this hallway. Now, you
can leave this. Is there a window on, the door?
Yeah. You can peek through the window. It looks like Zane is battling the scorpion. The spider just hit him. But he's still battling the scorpion. He's trying to gain some distance on it. All this is happening while you're looking out the window. Bethany comes barging through the door right in front of you. I'm here! What's going on?
I got caught up in a fight. We're gonna need some help.
Damn. So Bethany goes to look out the window as well. Oh my god, how many of them are there? So, you look out as well, and it's not just the scorpion and the spider now. The boar, the centipede, all of them are showing up now. Oh my god.
Bethany, we need to help him out.
Bethany opens the door.
Over here!
Zane goes, I'm on my... Gah! The scorpion just stings him right in the leg. You gotta make a decision. What do you do?
They're not ready to head. That I chopped off.
What happened?
Sarah's gonna go grab me the head that I chopped off. Of the big beast master thing.
Where's Sarah right now? She ran towards Bethany and she's with you now. Okay. So she ran?
Yeah. She ran to get the head. While she's doing
that.
You have
to tell her to get the head.
Sarah, go get me the head that I chopped off.
You want me to pick up a head? Oh.
Just do it for me, please.
I don't wanna.
It's really for Zane. He's there.
Don't worry, I'll go do it. Bethany goes, runs towards, runs back towards the main hall. It's just you and Sarah in that hallway now for a minute.
I'm gonna pop the candy.
You're popping the candy. Which one?
Both of them, sweet and sour.
Sweet and sour? You're gonna pop sweet and sour? Now what? Zane's trying to move towards you, but he's moving slower. He just got stung by the scorpion.
Honey.
I can do this, Thomas. I'm sorry.
I yell at Bethany. Bethany, hurry up.
I'm on my way back.
I pull out a cigarette. There was a dude who didn't smoke.
All right. I'm here. There's the head that you wanted.
Ugh. Give it to me. I take it and I run out there.
All right. So, as you're running out there with the head of the creature that you defeated, or Sarah defeated.
Yeah.
You're just now getting to Zane. And
a intimidation.
You're trying to use imitation. Also, you're barely coming in. I don't know what you're doing, but yeah, I can't barely hear you now.
Doing the thing with the black. Hold on. Okay.
So you're making it. You're running towards Zane. And you got the head. You pop both candies. And Zane's showing. Oh, I'm sorry, Thomas. He's not close to you yet, but you can tell that's what he said because you're staring directly at him. As you're staring directly at him,
die for me.
As you say that, don't die on me. The Cerberus, the three-headed Cerberus that he so desperately wants to defeat, comes from around the corner and is rushing him right now. Okay.
I run to Zane and I try to... the beast here.
What are you doing?
I'm gonna run towards Zane for probably.
You keep cutting out. So, the Cerberus gets around the corner. It's about to bite Zane. What do you do? Using the three heads?
I'm gonna try to run to him and push him out the way.
You run up to. You can roll for that. See if you get there fast enough.
18.
Okay, you get there just fast enough. You push him out of the way, but now you take the damage from the three Cerberus. That's a 3d20. Let me see. Rolls.
One.
Okay, you take 27 damage.
Oh, that's not bad.
Could have been worse.
Yeah.
So, you push Zane out of the way. Zane's really low. Or no, he's about half. Zane takes, he is poisoned though, from the scorpion. You feel the three bites on you. You take 27 damage. And then... You're trying to back up? What are you doing?
I'm gonna try to intimidate him and hold up the head. Just to see where it goes.
Okay, let's see if this... use intimidation. The Cerberus throws your... uses
Yeah. The Cerberus uses your head, uses its three heads, one to hit the out of the face, and another one to try and bite you. Now this one you can dodge. You can try to dodge. Use a dex save.
I didn't do good on the intimidation.
Yeah. You didn't intimidate it.
18 on the dodge.
Nice. Okay. So it goes in to bite you, but you're just enough, and you swipe, get out of the way. You get out of the way. And Zane is real slow, beaten, bruised.
He's Bethany, come get Zane!
On my way! So you see Bethany come grab Zane. He's pulling him back into the backyard. From the backyard into the manor.
Fuck it. Y'all want to play? Y'all don't want to play nice? Fuck it. I'll play angry too. Pull out my katana and get in a stance.
Okay, so you're readying yourself. So when you ready yourself, you give disadvantage to all attacks coming in. To hit.
Have a disadvantage?
They have a disadvantage when coming in.
Okay. Yeah, I'm ready up.
So they're gonna try to attack. Let me see. See if it hits you. It does not. So the three Cerberus bites are trying to come in to attack you. But just in time, you get out of the way. Okay. Actually, the 27 damage you took, make that like a 25 heal for 2, because you took the candy earlier. So for this combat.
We got 60.
Okay. So the Cerberus tries to bite you. But as you see the Cerberus try to bite you and miss, you see all the other monsters closing in on you.
Can I counterattack and try to ride the Cerberus?
You can try, yeah. So you dodge out of those Cerberus' bite path, and you're trying to ride it?
No, I'm just going to counterattack it.
Counterattack it, okay. So, let's see.
Wow.
So, it sees you trying to... One of the heads... See you trying to counterattack it and bites your hand. Now, it only bit your hand with one of the bites, so you don't take a lot of damage. 1d10 damage. So you take 9. And after you take the damage from the attempted counterattack, you see the other monsters closing in on you. What do you want to do? It's now about, like, I'd say 8, 9 in the morning. Just keeping track of time.
Take a big hit of the cigarette.
You taking a big hit of that cig?
What would my father do?
Are we going for an anime protagonist moment? Think back to your father.
What would my
You feel would a sort of hatred for your father, for what he did. But can't help but still... love him for all the memories you hold together.
Nathan, you can watch my back real quick?
I'm inside with Zane. Sorry about that. Why don't you get in here?
I won't make it in time.
No, Thomas!
So, you see multiple monsters closing in on you now. You're not moving. You can focus in.
Another hit of the cigarette. If I die, at least I went out in a blazing glory. Standing there looking up into the sky, thinking of my father, thinking of mother, father, the moment, and...
You think of your mother, you think of the pork chops she used to make, you think of the father, and how all the nice times you had with your brother and your father as a boy. You miss the times you spent with Shane and Tess. You miss the times aboard... the Hook Pirates, and harnessing all that, you think about your goal. Your goal is to find your brother, is to find your father, and confront them about what happened. Your goal is to show your mother that you will be the greatest pirate to ever live, and you'll find what's there at the end of the Grand Line, what she used to talk about. She used to talk about things that the world government isn't supposed to know about, isn't supposed to control, secrets they don't want getting out. You think about all of this, and then finally you think about yourself. You think about, if I die here, I'll never become Pirate King. Using your conquerors that you can't control up until this point, all the monsters around you, the centipede, the Cerberus, all of them kneel. Some of them are knocked out. The boar, the rat, and the centipede all get knocked out. The Cerberus is on one knee, and the lion is barely holding on, as well as all the other creatures. They're either unconscious or on one knee holding on. Wait! Ugh! That presence! Is that the color of the Supreme King? So you're focused in right now. You did not hear that. But that is something that he says. And Zane goes, what was that? Zane gets knocked out. Sarah gets knocked out. And you standing there over everyone, either unconscious or on a knee, that takes a lot out of you. And you don't have much stamina.
We need to find that key.
We do. Get back in here for now. So you run back inside. You walk inside, the door slams. Bethany goes, I didn't know you had that power. My captain used to have that power as well. Or I suppose she still does.
Your captain?
Thomas, I used to be on a very powerful crew in the Grand Line, sailing under the flag of a Yonko, one of the four emperors. I don't like to talk about my past. I came to the West Blue to get away from all that. But I thought you should know.
Do you know my whole name?
Your whole name? Wait. Are you a D? My captain is a D as well.
My name is Thomas D. Blau.
Gods, you have the potential to change this world.
Why do you think I want to conquer the Grand Line? Nasty animals will not get in my way, even if it kills me.
That's a solid resolve, Thomas. Alright. You asked earlier if you wanted me to join your crew.
Indeed.
If you'll have me, I'd like to join the crew of Thomas D. Lau. He reaches out his hand. Will you have me on?
There's always room for you, Bethany.
Alright.
I reach out. Grab his hand. Welcome aboard, Bethany.
To be continued.
Earlier in the night, two men walk through a maze. It's not too far away from here now. There's a pause of stillness in the night's air as Zane takes in his surroundings before replying to the interesting labyrinth dweller.
Daniel, I'm not a fan of the runaround. Just take me to the Cerberus and you'll get your money. 50,000 berry.
While I'm quite a fan of berry, there's only one map to the treasure I seek. And those naive fools are going to stir up all kinds of trouble in the center of this maze. He pauses. Which just might be the thing I need.
It's got nothing to do with me, but why do you want this map so bad anyway?
Daniel moves his head slightly to left and right before replying. A colleague of mine lost it here quite a while ago while he was on this island. It leads to something he was experimenting with. He never did let me near it. Afraid I might steal it for myself. Daniel seems to be muttering something to himself that Zane cannot hear. If only I'd taken a bite when I had the chance. Daniel stops for a moment to listen intently to the surroundings before continuing.
Well, that's all nice, but frankly, I shouldn't have asked. Even I understand there are some people in this world I shouldn't mess with. All I want is closure. Are we close?
The two of them round a corner that seems to be a dead end as Zane turns to look for Daniel. He hears laughing. And he doesn't see Daniel anywhere.
I've had a hunch where this map is. Or should I say, who has this map for quite a while now? But I haven't been able to confirm my suspicions until that woman is driven out of her shack, and after tonight, she won't be able to stay here any longer.
The voice of Daniel is heard throughout the maze in every direction Zane turns to, until a final sentence is heard right behind him, as if Daniel is whispering into his ear.
Maybe I should do something about that.
Zane immediately turns his head to look, but Daniel is not there. As he takes in his surroundings, he's alone in the darkness of the maze.
Damn. Anyone ever tell you that you're one creepy bastard?
Zane gathers himself, taking a knee at the dead end. A few minutes pass before he contemplates what he should do next. A loud sound can be heard coming from the center of the maze suddenly. It sounds as if it's a screech from a creature. The ground shakes, and many more sounds can be heard from the maze, this time coming towards Zane.
Shit, did that guy betray me?
Zane throws his back towards the hedge wall in order to hide his presence. Zane's voice drops into his throat. The beast he's been looking for this entire time. His former dog and the creature that killed his wife. The beast isn't alone, as other beasts are following it. Moving fast towards the direction Zane and Daniel came from.
I suppose that's one way of leading me to him. Zane, being as quiet as possible, follows the beast, but even when he made noise, he notices the beast deliberately ignore him.
He reaches the center of the maze after making many turns. Before him is a large manor. He comments,
I haven't been here in a long time.
He catches movement of all the beasts concentrating on the manor.
Looks like those two just might need my help.
He analyzes the situation.
It looks like the entrance is blocked off by those things.
His eye rests on the top floor window.
I wonder...